If you guys are kind of driving your own bus here, you're in a unique situation, and you guys have been able to travel a lot with your experiences around the world and in the United States. If you were granted 2 weeks right today, and we're going to go through the pictures of a lot of the stuff you all have done and people you've met, no place to be, no responsibilities, 14 calendar days, 10 business days, where do you go? Who do you take with you? What do you do? Patrick, John, you want to start with it, or do you want me to flip it back to Patrick Henry?
What do you think, buddy?
Well, I mean...
You ready?
I really couldn't... I mean, personally, if I was free that long,
right?
I'd probably... I really love game shows, so I'd probably do that. But in all honesty, I do have top destinations that I'd like to go.
Go for it.
I'd really like to go... I think my top four well, five, actually. Australia, Ireland, Scotland, Israel, and this last one kind of surprises some people, Zimbabwe.
What the? Zimbabwe?
Yeah. It's actually interesting. We had a project. It was my freshman year of high school, and we were studying Africa for geography, and we had this project where we had to pretend travel to three countries in Africa where they have big tourist attractions and, make an itinerary, write sort of a journal about what you did there.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the countries I ended up choosing was Zimbabwe. And for me, whenever we travel to certain locations, people like to travel and see the sights. Well, for me, it's all about sound.
Mm-hmm.
And Zimbabwe has, if it's not the world's largest, it's one of the world's largest waterfalls. It's called Victoria Falls. I think the residents nickname it the smoke that thunders or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it would, I actually do have, because I have a wide collection of sound effects CDs that have all these different sounds on it. And I do happen to have a sound of Victoria Falls on one of those CDs. But I think it would be really great to go up and to go to Zimbabwe and go to Victoria Falls and actually...
Wow.
Hear it live in person.
That's great.
As a matter of fact, when we did our Extreme Makeover, I'll go ahead and mention this.
Sure.
We went to London,
mm-hmm.
and one of the things I look forward to in London is on another one of those CDs, I had the sound of Big Ben, the big bell in London Tower. I have the Big Ben sound striking 12 o'clock, so I really wanted to go to London to hear Big Ben live and in person. So
nice.
Got that opportunity, and that was really amazing.
It's interesting what I picked up on. The sounds is what matters to you. That makes sense.
Yes.
It makes total sense. Your turn.
I don't really have a bucket list of places I want to go. Patrick's been, so wonderful. He's taken his mother and me to four continents.
Some great pictures.
And, there's... there's so many tremendous things to see in our world,
sure.
In our country. I mean, I have been very fortunate to travel to 49 of our 50 states.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't been to Alaska yet, but it's just a matter of time.
There you go.
Just a matter of time.
You
a travel agent watching this show, Patrick's list sounded pretty good.
Yeah, I like it.
There's so many neat things to see in the world. The Parthenon and the Colosseum and mm-hmm. Eiffel Tower and.
Sure.
You just go on and on with all these famous world landmarks that would be tremendous to see. And maybe I'll see them and maybe I won't. I don't know.
Who knows what the future holds for the Hughes boys.
Absolutely.